Hey, what's going on? It's your boy Mook, the Easy Man, a.k.a. Mr. O.D.A. Where you go, your bitch know me. And I want to give a shout out to Video City. You heard? Holla at your boy, Double R. Easy.
What's up, guys? It's your girl Chanel, and I am at Universal Recording Studios in Soho. A little later on in the show, we have an exclusive interview with the producer slash rapper Mike Jagger, so make sure you guys stay tuned.
Hey, Video City, this is your girl Swaya Times, and we are at Hotel Chantel in downtown Manhattan. I have a great interview with the sexy Cherry Martinez coming right up. Keep it locked.
What's up, it's your girl Dominique, it's Video City. We're in the K9 store for another Hot Top 5 video countdown. I'm here with my DJ, Sean G. We'll chop it up with him in a minute. At number 5, we have Jarrell Walker with The Missing Pieces.
They told me I should quit. That I was out of shape, it wasn't fit to do the things of which I wanted. It had added on my list. I'm on that shit you can't pronounce, just like a nigga with a list. I'm trying to find it, the missing pieces to the puzzle. My name's about to bubble, so I swore I'm working double to break even with my idols. Cause I'm way beyond my rivals, put my name into this drive to bring a lucky team. The title of the world's coming to an end, so my nose is in my Bible. They call it lame, but that's the source of my survival.
Say what you want.
Bet I'll be the last man standing. I spit that gospel, nigga, word to Fred Hammond. Don't get it twisted, in case you missed it. I'm still rolling around with niggas who keeping that heat in the steady assistant. I should call them up when I get pissed, cause it ain't never been nothing but dinner. Stop all what they doing to come make a visit to where I am. This man, like a sweat, like I'm dealing with this puzzle. They say the sun just shines brighter after dealing with a struggle. I'm just trying to find the missing pieces to this puzzle. It's like it's too much on my plate, I'm trying to juggle.
Hey, Video City, this is your girl, Toya Times. I am at Hotel Chantel with the lovely Cherry Martinez. How are you today?
Hi.
How you doing, girl? Well, we're here in the city tonight. We're having an event. And it's close to the holidays, we're having a turkey drive. There's a lot of people who are coming out to support families in need. And Cherry's here to support that cause. And I want to talk to you, Cherry, about what's going on with you. You know, I know you have a lot going on. I know you just launched your website, Cherry
yes.
on Top. Tell me about that.
Well, Cherry on Top is a webzine formatted website. You know, fashion, sports, celebrity news, you know, high-tech information, movie reviews, television, hotspots, restaurants, exclusive videos,
awesome.
Exclusive content, Cherry's Nails of the Week. Okay, we have my Nails of the Week.
I love the nails. They're very nice, actually.
And listen, I want to show you my toes.
Please do show me the toes.
Can I show you the
yes, toes? We want to see
okay.
the toes.
Toes, look, they're gold.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
Nice.
That's
nice.
How we're doing it, mamacita. That's how we're doing it.
I love the toes. Very, very nice.
Thank
okay.
you.
So there's, have you been getting a lot of traffic with the website? How's that going?
Everything good? We're a baby. We've been up for, I've owned the domain for a while, and I threw up, you know, just some blogs and, you know, little things that interested me as far as art is concerned. But we officially, you know, came with a whole staff probably about 4 months ago, and we revamped everything, the style of the site, you know, the direction, and the content. And, you know, it's been doing phenomenal. I'm amazed.
You're
I can't believe it.
Awesome. That's great.
I can't believe it.
And I know the way you're promoting your site as well, you have Cherry Girls. Now tell me about the Cherry Girls that you have.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're not strippers from Thailand, okay? The Cherry Girls are... they're an extension of me. Those are my girls that hold me down. We're, you know, it's like a street team, but one step higher, you know, because they're about getting money, they're bosses, and they're talented. You know what I mean? They got that boss mentality, and I feel like there are so many man organizations out there.
There is.
Okay, I'm not going to name any, but there are some there man is. Organizations out there. And I was like, you know what? I have not heard of a woman on the radio actually start a movement and really make it pop. So I said, you know what? Let's do the Cherry Girls. You know, actually, it was my husband's idea. He was like, you know what, babe? Meet the Cherry Girls. Let's do the Cherry Girls. And you know, it's just, it's working.
That's
it's
awesome. Popping.
I love it.
And you're so busy. I listen to you at night.
Sexy in the City. Late night.
Sexy in the City. Awesome. You do very well at night. You're just so busy. Is there any other projects that you have going on besides the website, besides radio, anything else you have going on?
Oh my goodness. I just learned how to DJ. I'm so excited. And
awesome.
I'm going to leave it there. Put it like this. I have equipment at my house. So don't sleep. Am I looking to, you know, be some like DJ up in the club getting it crunk, crunk, crunk? No. But I feel like there's a market for me. I feel like there are high-ended swaggy events that I could do. I feel like for Fashion Week, why not? I feel like, you know, Kim Kardashian, her wedding, why not? You know, I feel like there are a lot of things that a Nike event, you know, the Louis Vuitton opening of a new branch. Why couldn't I do that? So yeah, that's the direction I'm going. I'm keeping it high end, I'm keeping it expensive, and I'm keeping it sexy.
You are very sexy indeed, Cherry. Thank you so much for interviewing with us. And I hope you have a great night and hope you enjoy yourself with the turkey drive. I know you have other places to be right now, but thank you.
Thank you so much. Smooches. Check me out, Power 105.1.
Oh, and Twitter. Tell me your Twitter.
Twitter at Cherry Martinez. I'm on Facebook. And, of course, the site, www.cherryontop.com.
Thank you, Cherry. And this is your girl, Toya Times. You can also follow me on Twitter at Toya Times. And thank you for watching.
What's up, it's Video City. It's your girl, Dominique. That's my DJ, Sean G. Coming at number four, we have Sean Hines featuring Josh Sean with Nancy Reagan.
She was with me through the thick and thin, running through the streets, hard body, brought a player in. Kept the stir fry season on the stovetop, 5-inch heels, nice curves with the model walk. Baby, we could have took it to the mountaintop and kept it going straight from there. We ain't had to stop. Or was it just a fairy tale? Knew about my resi in the streets, chasing every sale. Yeah, you know I still kept it real with her. Then my 1-2, boy, I still played the field with her. Mapped it out, dog, I had to get the clear picture. Couldn't see myself on top of fine there with her. Huh. Guess it's how it play out. Shorty got stressed and she let the shit fade out. But before you need to go, I asked her one more time to stay and she said no.
Chill.
Guys, welcome back. So we're about to go check out my boy Mike Jagger, who's in the studio right now. Hey, what's up? How are you?
How are you?
I'm good. So I'm here with Video City. Say hi. All right, so for everyone who doesn't know, this is my boy Mike Jagger, rapper / producer. He's a musical genius. Okay, so how you been?
Working hard, man, you know, just working on 11:30, you know, promoting the 11th hour, shooting videos, the usual.
That's good. Sounds good. So I always feel to understand the artist, you know, we have to start from way back. Mm-hmm. So tell us a little bit about your childhood growing up. You know, how was that? Because you said you were raised in Delaware, but you were born in New York?
Yeah, my family's from New York. I was raised in Delaware. Me and my sister, I have a sister, older sister, whatever. We were both raised in Delaware. But, you know, I lived with my father for most of my initial years or whatever, you know. But we went through a lot, and I talk about that a lot on 11th Hour, like on songs like Away. Like, I talk about the hardships we went through, like living in a house with no electricity, no running water. You know, just all types of things.
Wow, so you grew up in, like, a lot of poverty?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, yes and no. You know, we had our highs and our lows, but we had a lot of lows, so that kind of motivated me in life in general. And then, you know, on the record, I talk about a lot about my relationship with my mother and just things that I've seen in my life, you know?
Mm-hmm. So when did you start producing?
I started producing, like, probably, like, around age 13, 14, you know? Really, like, I had a mentor. His name is Tony Visionary. He taught me how to produce the right way. Not knocking anybody that starts out on, like, programs or anything, but, like, I started out with the MPC, like, if you don't know, like, Kanye uses that, you sort of be amazed he was using that. Okay. Like, you know, I started out with all the proper gear, and I had the right mentors, and they kind of, you know, taught me music theory and things like that, and, you know, just got the ball rolling.
So I read a little bit that in Delaware, you were doing some producing there, too, right? At 16, you were noted for, what was that?
Yeah, I started out in a group called Baseline. You know, lots of family friends, shout out to them, I love them to death. I was in a group. And we did a lot of international touring in London, England, Sheffield, England. We did the Vote or Die tour with Diddy for a stop or two, some stops on the Scream tour. So, you know, that was like my initial foundation for what I'm doing now.
And you were just 16?
Yeah, I was like 14 when I did that one. I was 14 when we went to Europe for the first time and really started like getting out. So that kind of shaped my musical palette now that you hear is a very worldly sound mixed with, like, you know, what we know in America and what we love, like, you know, in the culture or whatever, but with, you know, some other things sprinkled in.
Keep it international. So tell me, like, who were some of your influences growing up?
I mean, I had a lot. Like, my mother listened to a lot of the Philly sound, so, like, you know, she listened to a lot of Erykah Badu. Shout out to James Poyser, Rich Nichols, and all them. Those are some good friends of mine. But she listened to Erykah, Tribe. My father, yo, he hated like music with cursing in it, so he actually wanted me to listen to Will Smith. Shout out to Will Smith. You know, I'm from Delaware, Philly and Delaware are real close, so, you know, we got a lot of that Philly sound. Just a lot of good music. Like, I love B.I.G. when I was younger. I actually had this story that I tell a lot about how I actually got into music.
Tell it.
I was, like I told you, when I lived with my father, we didn't have any electricity or running water, but he had got me this radio. Whatever, so I had batteries in the radio or whatever. And so this chick, one day my dad was walking to the liquor store. Let me start from the beginning. I was supposed to go fast forward. My dad was walking to the liquor store or whatever, and, like, this chick was throwing her boyfriend out. And, like, you know, stuff is everywhere. It's all over the lawn or whatever. But I see this box of tapes or whatever. It was, like, everything you could think of in there. Biggie, DMX, Jay-Z, anything you could possibly think of that was hot, like, around the 90s. So I, like, after we walked home, I asked my dad if I could stay outside and play. Like, ran back around the corner, grabbed that box and dipped, because he wasn't going to notice anyway. His stuff was all over the place. And I just took that box of tapes home, and I kind of studied. Like, that was almost like my school, because I caught up late. Actually, I didn't know B.I.G. was dead. Like, I didn't know a lot of things that other people knew. So, yeah.
That's interesting. So tell us about the 11th Hour. Tell us about... I want to know everything, you know. What is the 11th Hour? Tell me.
Yeah, the 11th Hour really represents where I felt like I was at. I'm still there to me mentally, but, like, the 11th Hour really represents how I feel. Like, I didn't make a plan B or C. Like, this is my plan A, so I stick to that every day. This is all I think about. I wake up and I start writing. I go to sleep and I'm thinking about beats, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So the 11th Hour it was telling you where I was at in a lot of the songs, telling you I was reflecting on certain things I was mad at, certain aspirations I have. And it really just tells a story of, like, a 19, 20-year-old kid trying to find himself in the world.
That mixtape is really, it's noted. If you guys haven't listened to it, make sure you guys go download that. Also, I saw you in The Source recently on Side Hype. Hey, how was that? That must feel good.
Yes. Shout out to my man Bonsu. Shout out to the whole Source family. That was an honor right there. Because, you know, a lot of people that I look up to, Biggie, Eminem, you go down the list, like, legendary people that had that. So it felt great to get that honor, you know? Yeah.
All right. So tell them where they could find your music. Where can they download your mixtape? Where can they catch up?
MikeJager.com. 2 G's, 2 R's. That's MikeJager. JAGGERR.
What else? Twitter, they want to talk to you.
Everything is super, like, everything's the same. So Twitter/MikeJager, MikeJager.com. You go to that website, you'll find everything. It connects you to all the dots and all that, you know.
Well, that sounds good. Make sure you guys go check out my boy, Mike Jagger. He is official. All right, so Video City, back to you.
What's up?